Good evening. History in the making in Washington today as the House votes on the impeachment of President Trump.
Alice Barr has been watching from Capitol Hill.
The weight of history hangs over the U.S. Capitol today as the House holds its final vote on the impeachment of President Trump.
Today we are here to defend democracy for the people.
One by one, representatives speaking in support or opposition.
Today is going to be a lot of things. What it is not is fair. What it is not is about the truth.
All with an eye toward the legacy of impeaching an American president for only the third time.
Dear Ellie and James.
Congressman Joe Kennedy reading a letter telling his children why he's voting yes.
He broke our laws. He threatened our security.
Democrats hold the majority in the House, and nearly everyone supports impeaching the president for abusing his power and obstructing Congress. President Trump watching and fuming, tweeting, "Can you believe I will be impeached today?" In the middle of the House debate, the president leaving Washington for a campaign rally in Michigan. Democrats insisting the case against him is clear.
The president committed constitutional crimes. The president's crimes are impeachable.
While Republicans line up solidly to defend President Trump.
I believe this is the most unfair, politically biased, rigged process.
A process now being written into history with the Republican-controlled Senate eager to begin the next chapter. Clerk will call
the roll. Twin States News spoke with people of Meridian about their thoughts on the impeachment and their split.
It's unfortunate that the country is so divided and that everything's so divided. You know, I feel that it's negatively affecting everything when, you know, at the end of the day, the person we elect, whether, you know, they be Democrat, Republican, or independent, they're just trying to do what's best for the country. And I feel like they're hindering that tremendously right now by dragging out this impeachment and everything else they've been doing for the last 3 years.
I think they're just trying to put a hold on some of the things that the president is doing. For as getting other countries to interfere in our election, if that's what the case is, because they have several people that the president have basically blocked from testifying. Now, whether they would have testified in his favor, I believe he would let them talk. But if they wasn't, and if they were going to tell the truth, I mean, shut them up.